This is Tomorrowpictures.TV.
I didn't breathe.
George Floyd.
What's going on in Washington and D.C.? We're going to do something that people haven't seen before.
In the brief span of 30-odd years, the world has seen an inventor's dream.
This is no simple reform.
Freedom and human dignity.
It really is a revolution.
You've got to ask yourself a question.
Teach you how to kill.
Do I feel lucky?
We're like the stupid people.
Far more powerful than anything man has yet devised.
Inspiration and hope.
Life is visceral.
Tearing down that wall.
Because we had stupid politicians doing stupid things.
Let's get this straight.
The United States.
Preeminently the time.
To speak the truth.
Enough out his life.
Bold truth, frankly, and boldly.
Stupid.
Socialism does not work. It's been proven time and time and time and time again.
What about European countries that are...
All right, so if you...
Like who?
Denmark.
Sweden.
Denmark.
Sweden.
Germany.
They were?
What?
No, they work out.
In fact, they prospered.
They
were.
They prospered. They're some of the happiest countries in the world.
I just read that today.
I don't think he changes country to a socialist country. I think he wants to bring some socialist ideas.
Principles.
To a capitalist country.
Listen. If he gets in and Ted Cruz gets in, I don't like Ted Cruz, I might switch to the Democratic Party and vote for Bernie if it's not between him and Trump. I'm really stuck in the middle. I'm not 100% gung-ho Trump.
Do you have any other concerns you want to share with us today?
Anyone have any concerns?
Do you have any concerns?
About the environment.
He wants to close the Environmental Protection Agency, which I don't even think that's what it's called, but he wants to stop it. Our environment is... Scientists have proven that global warming is a thing. We need to make sure we protect our country and our state.
She's the secretary of cleanup club at our school, so
yeah,
she knows.
I'm the secretary of the environmental club at my school, so I'm very, very strong about that.
Is there a lot of division among the students caused by this campaign?
Being that I'm on the college campaign, I wasn't aware because it wasn't a big issue until we found out Trump was coming, which wasn't not too long ago. I found out, I believe was on maybe Friday or Thursday, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people found out around the same time. So this was kind of like a spontaneous. Like for me, example, I'm a musician. I'm in some ensembles here at the university. There are people over there that I performed next to that I didn't even know, like, support this man. So it was like, I was totally fine with that. But the fact that they have been, I do believe that they have been manipulated to, you know, hide the fact because they grow in numbers. Because they're just as afraid as we are. I know that. They're afraid of losing. They're afraid that they might go down under. And right now, it seems like they just might win. It may seem like Trump just might win.
Do you feel safe out here today?
When I'm on this side, yes, I feel safe. When I cross back over into the Trump side, I do always make sure I'm with a buddy. I always make sure that I hide anything that would show that I'm for not going for Trump. But I don't feel safe crossing over to the other side, no.
Do you have any issues with his policies for education?
Donald Trump? To be honest, I'm honestly not too sure. I'm not even gonna lie, I'm not too sure.
Tonight we'd like to say a special thanks. We don't have much time to thank everybody, and especially to our friends in business and to our wonderful friends here and all of you out there for your great loyalty.
Justice will be served.
I would simply like to say that I think this has been one of the great days of America.